you have a plan to increase security in places like that?
The district has up-to-date and well-tested emergency response plans. This program was produced by Lenape District Television.
Hi, we're at Seneca High School today for a girls' basketball game between the Seneca Golden Eagles and the Shawnee Renegades. I'm Nick Webb, and this is Scott Gloss.
Hi, Nick.
Scott, what do you think of the game today?
Well, Nick, this is going to be a very competitive matchup. The Renegades have been up and down so far this year. The Golden Eagles have a brand new coach. They're 3-4. I'll tell you what, these are two evenly matched teams, Nick. I look for a great contest here tonight on LDTV.
After these brief messages.
Today's game on LDTV Sports, sponsored by Deborah Heart and Lung Center, where experience matters. 800-555-1990, www.deborah.org. Philadelphia Wholesale Produce Market, all the best, all right here. 215-336-3003, or on the web at www.pwpm.net. Comegno Law Group, specializing in general and special education law, representing individuals, families, public boards of education, and independent schools. 888-313-IDEA or comegnolaw.com. Wilmore School of Gymnastics and Cheer, where every child is special. Located on Briggs Road in Mount Laurel. 856-234-5292. Medford Village Car Care, serving the area's car care needs for 30 years. Located at 11 North Main Street in Medford. 609-654-4023. And on the web at mvcc-nj.com. And by Heads Up, Eyes Forward. Please never drive distracted. www.lrhsd.org/heads-up. For information on how your business can become a sponsor of LDTV Sports, contact Joe Malagrana, LDTV Underwriting Manager, at 609-268-2000, extension 8680, or by email, jmalagrana@lrhsd.org.
All right, getting ready for this big game, Scott?
Yeah, we're back here at Seneca High School. You see the cheerleaders out there, pre-game stuff going on. They're going to read the NJSIA announcement. Interesting note here, and I didn't know this, one of the assistant coaches over there for Shawnee tonight, a young lady by the name of Danielle Hubbs, was a Seneca student not too long ago, and it's nice to see Miss Hubbs back. She student taught this semester at Shawnee as chemistry, and now she's on the Shawnee coaching staff. She played here at Seneca under Coach Kenevan, a previous girls coach. Of course, we have a new coach here at Seneca in Coach Creel. Shawnee coach has been around for 4 years now, I believe, if I recall. Lauren Creel's first year here at Seneca.
All right.
Number 4, Aaron Wicker. Number 12, Equitable.
It's time now for the AXA Equitable keys to the game, providing millions of customers with life insurance and annuities and other need-based products since 1859. AXA Equitable, Be life confident.
Number 11, Erica Barr.
It's time now. Yeah.
Shawnee needs to hold
Seneca to less than 40 points today.
Yeah, Shawnee's not a high-scoring team. The Golden Eagles can put some points up. So one of the things Shawnee's defense has to limit opportunities and points for Seneca tonight.
Well, Seneca really has to control the tempo in this game, Scott.
Yes, they do, Nick, and I'll tell you what that means. That means they have to set the pace here tonight. They can't play to Shawnee's tempo. Seneca has to play their own game.
Mm-hmm. And a big key to this game is going to be rebounding.
Yeah, especially on the offensive end. Both of these teams take a lot of shots. Maybe not the greatest percentage shooting teams, either one. So if offensive rebounds become a factor for putbacks and second and third chances, it could make a difference in tonight's contest.
And that has been Axel Ekelund's keys to the game.
During the introductions now of the starting lineups. Should be a great contest. Shawnee coach Chrissy McGovern in her fourth year. As I said, her one assistant is Julie McGrory. The other is former Seneca student Danny Hubbs. On the other side, you have Lauren Creel in her first season here at Seneca. She is the former head coach at Pennsauken High School. She still has Sam Myra on her staff. Her lead assistant is Miss Timpano, and also the new coach that's joined her at Lee Timpano, and then Nicole Jones.
So. This is a big game for all the coaches. Seneca and Shawnee is a big rivalry. These games
always
get heated.
Yes, and it's also youth night here tonight, so some of the younger girls basketball players are out here. We have, you see the Seneca girls team there, Nick, and we have Seneca student Tiffany Briscoe singing the national anthem for us tonight. It's a nice thing they do here at Seneca. They try to get a student to sing, and most schools do, try to get them to sing the anthem, get them involved. Fine rendition by the national anthem by Tiffany Briscoe. So I would be remiss, Nick Webb, in not welcoming you to the LDTV broadcast crew. So welcome.
Well, thank you,
Scott.
Your
first game. You did an excellent job on the introduction. I have the utmost of confidence. You're going to do a great job here tonight. And what? You're only a freshman, right?
I am only a freshman.
So I get you for 4 years, bud. That's cool. Yeah. I like that. You're the first Seneca student we've had in a long time on LDTV. So welcome aboard.
Thank you. I'm very excited to keep. Broadcasting to LDTV for the next 4 years.
So this is going to be a game where I think, you know, in the early part, if one team gets out to a big run, I think that could really be detrimental, obviously, score-wise. But, you know, you want to keep your momentum going. You don't want to fall behind early, get yourself in a hole. So I think the first, let's say, 2 or 3 minutes of tonight's contest may be very important to both squads. Who can get out to that early lead and who can maintain their cool, I guess, their calm, their collective team effort.
Yes, Scott. In these division sister schools matches. Morale is a big factor always.
Play-by-play underway, and with your play-by-play, we welcome aboard Nick Webb to give us the play-by-play tonight.
It's a pass to Megan Glenn has the ball, dribbling up. Passes to number 23, Natalie Maliska. Number 21 has the ball, Rachel Rosborough. It's under the hoop. Jenna Denora shoots, misses. It's recovered by Shawnee. They're coming down the court. Passes to number 4, Erin Wicker.
Very nice block there by Natalie Malesko, getting back on defense.
Pass in by number 1, number 21, Molly Becker. Molly Becker with the ball, passes. Recovered by Seneca, number 21, Rachel Rosborough. Passes back to Megan Glenn.
Nice job there by Roseborough. She saw she was cut off on the drive, and so she backed it back out to try to set up the offense.
Jenna Denora's passes. Shot by Natalie Malesko.
Interesting note about Natalie Malesko. She is a transfer from Shawnee, so she had to sit out for a little bit of time before she got to play here at Seneca. But now she is in the lineup and usually a starting lineup. So kind of maybe a little, a little excitement there for Natalie to play against some of her former teammates.
Has to be a lot of incentive to play her best against people that she used to play with. Shawnee has the ball. Number 4, Erin Wicker dribbling up. Number 11, Eric Barr. Shawnee shoots. It's missed, but rebound's taken by number 12.
There, we talked about offensive rebounds, you know, earlier. And there was Shawnee with 3 attempts. On the 3rd attempt, they're going to get a foul and go to the line to shoot a couple of free throws. Oh, no, they call it on the floor, so it'll be Shawnee ball out.
Passed in by number 21, Molly Becker. Number 23, Lauren Lodge. Shawnee has the ball, passes it back to Molly Becker.
Yeah, Beckler seems to run the offense here for Shawnee.
Shawnee shoots, misses. Seneca picks up the rebound. It's fighting on the floor. It's a jump ball.
Possession for Shawnee. Of course, there are no more jump balls except the beginning of the game, and now they have a possession arrow, and the possession arrow was pointing for Shawnee. Now once they inbound, the possession arrow will switch, and the next jump ball will go to Seneca.
Thank you, Scott.
And there it is, almost like I was prophetic in that.
Seneca has the ball in with number. Rachel Rosborough passes it in. Erica Rosborough is driving up. She passes it back to Megan Glenn. Megan Glenn's holding. Passes. Number 10, Jenna Birnbaum Kaminsky. Erica Rosborough has the ball again. Oh, that's a shot made by Megan Glenn.
Three-pointer for Megan Glenn, and Seneca draws first blood and gets on the board tonight with a three-pointer from Megan Glenn.
Seneca really has to set the pace early tonight. Shawnee shoots under the net.
It's going to be a shooting foul, so we'll get 2. We'll see who it's on here. Number 23, Natalie Malesko, her first personal foul, second team foul on the Golden Eagles. And number 23, Lauren Lodge goes to the line, makes the first one.
Missed.
Nice rebound.
Covered. And Seneca has the ball. Taken right from the hands of number 12, Olivia Shock. Seneca's under the net, shooting by Jenna Denoris. Another rebound. We said those were going to be crucial in this game, but we didn't know how crucial until this game really started. So, foul.
Shawnee foul on Olivia Shuck, her first team foul on the Renegades. Gonna send Natalie Malesko to the line to shoot two shots here. Seneca up 3-1, chance for Malesko to increase the 2-point Golden Eagle lead.
She makes the first one.
First substitution of the game, Nick, looks like number 5, Cameron Morgan, checks in. Replaces number 4, Erin Wicker.
And she makes the second. Cameron Morgan has the ball. Passes it to Molly Beckler.
Ball deflected out of bounds off of Seneca. Renegade ball underneath their own offensive basket.
Shawnee's under the net. The shot all messed up by Seneca. They're under the net. Jenna Birnbaum-Kaminsky went under to shoot after driving it back up the court.
Natalie Malesko, that's going to be her second personal foul already early, 4 minutes into the first quarter, and I think we're going to see our first substitution for the Golden Eagles. Going to be number 11, Taylor Iacono. Going to replace Malesko, who sits with second foul.
Even though it has to be a heated game playing against your old school, you still have to be careful with the fouls like that. It can really
hurt the
team.
Absolutely. Nice defense there by number 21, Rachel Roseberg.
Iacono passes down the court. Shot by Jenna Birnbaum-Kaminsky. Shawnee has the ball again.
They got a travel. Traveling violation against number 5, Cameron Morgan. Will be a turnover, turns the ball back over to the Golden Eagles. Long lead pass for Iacono.
Iacono's under the net, shoots. Rebound, Shawnee has the rebound. Down the court. The shot. Rebound recovered by
Jenna Birnbaum-Kaminsky. A nice rebound there, and we're going to get a timeout. Looks like a 30-second timeout for Coach Creel. Little helter-skelter here in the first 5 minutes. Shawnee yet to make a field goal. Seneca just one field goal in the first 5 minutes, a three-pointer. Nerves, maybe. Sure, the girls know they're on LDTV. You know, that kind of hypes them up a little bit, Nick. I think you'll see him settle down after this timeout. It's a good timeout by Lauren Creel. It also gives Shawnee coach a chance to settle her troops down as well.
Seneca has to make sure, as we said earlier, in keys to game, they have to make sure they play at their own tempo. And do you think they're doing that so far, Scott?
I think they're playing the way Coach Creel would like them to. She likes an up-tempo offense, and they've done that. They've been solid on the defensive rebounds. Neither team is, as I said in the opening, neither team shoots a high percentage, you know, of baskets in terms of their field goal percentage. So rebounding is going to be a key, and I think both teams have done that pretty well. We have just one field goal between the two teams, and we're over halfway through the first quarter.
Emma Rosborough passes it in to Jenna. It's taken by number 14, Megan Glenn. But Shawnee has the ball now. She passes to Molly Beckler. Passes back. They're under the net, shooting.
Oh, they're going to get Denoris on that foul. Fourth team foul on the Golden Eagles. First on Jenna Denoris. Of course, for those of you who might not be familiar, once you get to seven, you get into the bonus situation where you'll shoot one and one. If you make the first, you get the second. So we have a long way to go, and it's per half, so.
Makes the first.
Erica Barr looking for the second, makes them both. Makes so all three of Shawnee's points have come via the free throw.
Scott, what do you think is going on? Why are there so many fouls this game so far?
Well, I think each team is trying to play tough defense, and there's nothing wrong with that. You know, Shawnee had a good drive there, and Denoris just committed the foul. That's good basketball. Take it when you get down low in the paint there, take it to the basket, force the other team either to give you the uncontested layup or foul you and go to the free throw line. Barr made both of her free throws.
Speaking of good physical defense, you see that disruption by Cameron Morgan?
Yes, I did. Well played. Kick out pass. Aaron shot.
Seneca is up the court. Iacono has the ball, passes back to Roseboro.
Roseboro kind of isolated here out there with number 21, Molly Beckler.
Passes to Birnbaum Kaminsky.
Megan Glenn there, number 14, just had the ball. She's got the only basket for Seneca so far. Looks like Iacono
shoots. Out of bounds. Shawnee ball.
Minute and a half, roughly, a little bit more than a minute and a half. 1:32 to go in the first quarter.
Beckler and Morgan really seem to run this Shawnee offense.
Agreed. They're both out high and looking to dump it in. Nice drive there.
Rebound by Megan Glenn. Errant pass to Birnbaum Kaminsky.
Jenna did a nice job there keeping the ball from going out of bounds and then saved it in, and Seneca maintained possession. Looking down low for Denoris, but nothing there. Good defense by Shawnee as well. Under a minute now in the first quarter.
Roseboro is driving. Passes to Birnbaum underneath.
And we're going to get a foul. Nice job by Jenna. Good drive there by Jenna Birnbaum Kaminsky to draw the foul. It's going to be on Olivia Shuck.
I believe that's her first foul of the game.
Yes, that's what they have up on the board. Jenna Birnbaum Kaminsky makes the first of the two free throws.
Seneca subbed in Lizzie Gazelle.
Actually, I think that last foul was on Olivia Shuck, my bad. It was number five. Both free throws made by Jenna Birnbaum Kaminsky. And they're going to get to Norris for her second foul. She swatted at it.
Shawnee just drove up the court on that one.
Fifth team foul now already on the Golden Eagles. Number five, Cameron Morgan, makes the first of two. She'll get the second here. And makes them both. Good free throw shooting for Shawnee, Nick, in this first quarter. They're 5 out of 6. They've only missed one, and that's all their points they have are 5 via free throws.
Even though Seneca is the only team to have made a field goal, if you make that many penalties, then you're going to give up some serious points.
Agreed. Got to limit your fouls, and they're going to be in danger of giving Shawnee bonus shots at this rate.
Osprey's driving. She shoots. Oh, almost makes it. Rebound recovered by Shawnee. Passes up the court. There's nobody in front of her. And she
can't get it to fall. Oh, and Rachel Roseboro goes end to end.
In the last second. That really helped Seneca out there. It was a close game, and they really needed those points to distance their lead.
Yeah, nice drive by Rachel Roseboro. Shawnee never had anybody step out to stop her drive, which surprised me. But Rachel Roseboro finishes it off just before the buzzer sounds. So one quarter in the books. And Shawnee is limited to no field goals, 5 free throws. Seneca with 2 field goals, 1 three-pointer, and 1, as you saw, Rachel Roseboro's basket, and 2 free throws in her own. So, as I mentioned earlier, Nick, neither team is shooting a high percentage. But as you see right there on your TV screen, at the end of one quarter of play, it's the Seneca Golden Eagles 9, the Shawnee Renegades 5. Good crowd here tonight, Nick, as we look over across the stands. We hear the Seneca Pep Band in the background. Pretty good turnout from both sides. You know, when the schools are as close as what Shawnee and Seneca are, just a few miles down the road, you get a lot of fans from both places.
I think high fan turnout is a common theme between Seneca-Shawnee games.
Yeah, you pretty much get them in every contest where there's, you know, fans allowed. You know, you probably don't find too many at a swim meet, or certainly not in my sport that I coach, golf. They're not allowed out there. So, but you get a football game, you get a basketball game, you get baseball games, you're going to get a good turnout from both sides. Second quarter about to get underway, and it looks like Seneca's going to have the ball in on the inbound and back to Nick Webb.
Roseboro, the scorer of the point at the, of the two-point layup at the end of the first quarter, now has the ball. Megan Glenn has it. Pass back to Roseboro. Roseboro's looking, but nobody seems to be open. Passes to Birnbaum, but it's broken up by Shawnee. Shawnee ball out. Cameron Morgan taking it up the field. Passes to Beckler.
That was Lauren Lodge on the drive. He couldn't get it to go, and then a foul is committed again. Number 11, that's going to be the first foul on Taylor Iacono, and that is the 6th team foul. So that means that from now on, any fouls against Seneca will result in free throws for the goal for the Renegades.
That could really end up hurting Seneca in this
sure
game.
Sure could. Cameron Morgan makes the first, looks for the second. Try to trim the Seneca lead down to 2.
And does. She makes it. Roseboro ball into Gazelle. Roseboro taking it up the field. And pass is taken by Shawnee. Pass to Cameron Morgan, has the ball, looking. Number 30, Sina Vaccarelli.
Number 22, Lizzie Gazelle draws her first foul, but that is their 7th team foul, so that means they will be in the bonus and they'll shoot 1-1. What that means is if number 30, Sienna Vaccarelli, makes the first, she will get a bonus shot and have a shot at making 2 free throws.
Makes the first. Missed the second, taken by Iacono. Roseboro has the ball.
Roseboro right at the top. Her and Maggie Glenn seem to run the offense, but there's a miscommunication, a bad errant pass, and turnover gives the ball back to Shawnee, and a couple of subs coming back in for Seneca. Number 23, Natalie Malesko, and number 12, Caitlin Birnbaum Kaminsky checks in now. So the twins are now in for the Golden Eagles.
Cameron Morgan has the ball, passes to Molly Beckler, and back to Morgan.
Oh, nice running shot by Cameron Morgan. She'll get the field goal and a foul. And quickly, Malesko came right back in, Nick, and got her third foul. So I think Coach Creel may have to take her right back out, and here she comes again. Iacono comes back in now. Cameron Morgan gonna shoot one shot to complete the old-fashioned three-point play. Nope, in and out.
Taken by Iacono to Rossborough. And Caitlin Birnbaum Kaminsky has the ball, pass to Iacono. Back to Megan Glenn. And pass broken up by Shawnee, number 12. Olivia Shuck with that drive.
Olivia Shuck jumped right into the passing lane there, but then at the other end, Shawnee commits their own turnover. Five blue, that's going to be Cameron Morgan's second personal foul. Only the third team foul on Shawnee, who has now taken the lead now, 10-9.
And without making a single field goal.
No, they made one. The Cameron Morgan made the last one when she was going for the three-point play. Mm. That's the only one they have, though. They're on a 5-0 run here to start quarter number two, though.
Shot, rebound taken by Birnbaum Kaminsky, that's Jenna, to Rossborough. Caitlin Birnbaum Kaminsky passes
nice
to Iacono.
Pass.
Shoots, and the rebound is taken by Shawnee.
Beckler over on the far side now driving, saw the opening, nice dish off.
Couldn't get it to fall. Beckler shoots, and now Seneca has up.
A mad scramble for the ball. Jump ball, possession, Shawnee. It's like Shawnee's has calling him a timeout here.
And this is the second time out of the game. We're now going to the Ivy Rehab play. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com.
This is a nice drive there, nice dish off. Couldn't get the shot to fall. Beckler goes
shot.
Back up with it and doesn't make it. Then the ball comes loose right here, and then you see eight players, roughly, diving at the loose ball. Eventually, the possession went to Shawnee because they had the possession arrow. So it'll be their ball to inbound. A little over 3 minutes into quarter number two. The Golden Eagles are yet to score here in the second quarter.
Number two, Gia Flamini had that ball.
Nice drive by Lodge, but then lost. Oh, and a bounce goes Shawnee's way.
Shot, but could not get it to fall.
That ball is bouncing around down there underneath the Seneca basket. It almost looks like a hot potato. Long shot by Glenn.
But it's recovered by Caitlin Bernbaum-Tomisky.
And it's still going to be Seneca ball. Lizzie Gazelle checking back in. Caitlin Bernbaum-Kaminsky checking out.
Megan Glenn has the ball. And that one was taken by Molly Becker.
Nice defense there by Iacono to knock off the pass. Looked like he was trying, looked like they were trying to get an underneath pass.
This underneath pass can be dangerous under the net. Lucky for Seneca that it was broken up.
I think we're going to have a blocking foul. Yes, we are. It's like Stephanie Hughesby is going to get called for the foul. Or did they call it on back? No, they called it on 11. Erica Barr. So Jenna Bernbaum-Kaminsky will go to the line. Misses the first. Rachel Roseborough checks back in now. Number 21 for the Golden Eagles.
Bernbaum-Kaminsky
misses both.
Shawnee taking it down the court. Molly Beckler passes it, and Seneca recovers the rebound.
Gazelle.
Roseborough has the ball.
Oh, going to call an offensive foul on Rachel Roseborough, so she used the elbow. That will be her second personal foul. It's their 19th foul. However, it's a possession foul, so you don't shoot those. So Shawnee will not get to go to the line.
Which is lucky for Seneca.
Good point. Of course, the bad news is their next free throw or next foul will be number 10, and then it's double bonus. So you don't even have the one and one anymore. You automatically get two shots.
Gia Flamini passes.
Lodge.
Shot by Flamini, and looks like Jenna Denoris got that one.
Nice pass. Nice pass from Roseborough to Bernbaum-Kaminsky.
Seneca's back in the lead, but only by one. Molly Beckler passes underneath.
Lizzie Gazelle, her second, and that is team foul number 10, so it'll be double bonus time for the Renegades. Going to the line will be number 12, Olivia Shuck.
And luckily for Seneca, she misses the first one.
Megan Glenn checks back in. Taylor Iacono comes out. And looks like Coach Creel with Seneca is going to call a timeout.
Let's take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com.
This is a great pass from Rachel Roseborough to Jenna Bernbaum-Kaminsky, and Jenna did a nice job underneath to get good position and up and in with the nice layup there. Her first basket of the game, she has two free throws. She is the Seneca leading scorer right now with 4 points for the Renegades. Cameron Morgan leads their team with 6 points. It's a low-scoring contest, as you see, 11-10 with about 2.5 minutes to go in the first half. Kind of what we expected, Nick. I didn't expect either of these teams to put up a 60 or 70 point night. They're known more for their defensive prowess than they are for their offensive firepower.
Like we said earlier in the keys to the game, it's important for Shawnee to hold Seneca, because we know Seneca can put up some points. And they seem to be doing that so far.
Yes, they do.
It's going in Shawnee's favor, especially since in these close-scoring games, penalties are so important.
And as you saw, Olivia Shuck was fouled on the floor. It was not a shooting foul, but because Seneca has 10 fouls, they are now in the double bonus, so Olivia Shuck will go to the line to shoot two shots.
Makes it. Rachel Rosborough. Pass to Gazelle. Back to Rosborough. Megan Glenn. And broken up.
Shuck with a steal.
Broken
and they're
going to
get Rosborough for a foul there. That's going to be her third personal, so the Golden Eagles are getting into a little bit of foul trouble here, Nick. They have two players with three fouls, number 23, Natalie Malesko, and 21, Rachel Roseborough. Both have three fouls in the first half. So I was going to say, you're going to see Coach take Rachel out here now. Taylor Iacono steps back in. She's been in and out here in the first half.
Makes the first one.
Shuck makes both free throws, and now it's 13-11. Shawnee, 13 points in the first half, 11 of them from the free throw line. Amazing.
Megan Glenn passes it up to Gazelle. Gazelle passes it to Denoris. Shoots, and the rebound is taken by Shawnee. Beckler's driving up, pass underneath to Lodge.
Offensive rebound by Molly Beckler and a putback. Yeah. 10-2 scoring in this quarter, and Shawnee's stepping up the defense now.
Oh.
Jump ball, possession, Seneca.
Ball in by Jenna Birnbaum-Kaminsky. Pass to Gazelle.
Trying to look for Denoris down low.
Drives. Toss it up. Oh.
They battle for it. And eventually Shuck comes down with it for Shawnee.
Pass up to Lodge.
Solid defense there by the Golden Eagles. Couple of subs coming back in for Shawnee now. Number 30, Sienna Vicarelli, and number 33, Stephanie Hughesby checks in. Shawnee ball underneath their offensive basket.
Shawnee pass underneath 33.
Nice defense by Akono, and then we're going to get a foul called on Vicarelli. Only the fifth team foul, so they're not in danger yet. They've got one foul to give. Only a minute 13 to go in the first half. Hasn't been a great quarter for the Golden Eagles. They went into the quarter with a four-point lead. They now trail by four.
Seneca seems to be slowing down, but let's hope they pick it up.
It's Glenn.
Glenn swapped by
double team nicely. Nice trap there. Mid. Center court trap to force the turnover.
Beckler shoots, still can't get it to fall.
I think that's going to be a foul called on number 21, Beckler, her first personal, now 16 foul. And with 42 seconds to go, Shawnee commits another foul. Seneca will go to the free throw line, whether it's shooting or non-shooting at this point.
Megan Glenn passed it up to Gazelle. Oh, seems to be a miscommunication by the...
Yep. Nice hustle by Icona to try to save it, but this was too far away from her.
That's Seneca's second miscommunication that has resulted in a pass going out.
Guns Cameron Morgan, number 5, and Olivia Shuck, number 12, checking back in. See if Coach McGovern of Shawnee tells the girls to hold it for one shot with just 20 seconds to go.
Certainly looks that way, they're passing around.
Morgan at the top of the key. Oh, it could have been a travel.
Shawnee got the rebound, but just could not get it to fall. Seneca's running up.
Oh, it's going to count. Megan Glenn almost made a, two-third court or one-third court shot there at the buzzer.
That would have been big for Seneca, but it would not have given them the lead.
So nice quarter for Shawnee. They outscored Seneca there 10-2. It's 15-11 now at the half. And as we said at the opener, neither of these teams shoot for a high percentage of field goals. Just 3 field goals in the whole first half for Seneca and only 2 field goals for Shawnee. So the whole half of basketball, just 5 field goals. But Shawnee has made their free throws, and that's what's counted. There we are at halftime. The score, the Shawnee Renegades 15, the Seneca Golden Eagles 11. We'll be back after these messages, Nick, for our second half this evening.
Today's game on LDTV Sports, sponsored by Deborah Heart and Lung Center, where experience matters. 800-555-1990, www.deborah.org. Philadelphia Wholesale Produce Market, all the best, all right here. 215-336-3003, or on the web at www.pwpm.net. Comegno Law Group, specializing in general and special education law, representing individuals, families, public boards of education, and independent schools. 888-313-IDEA or comegnolaw.com. Wilmore School of Gymnastics and Cheer, where every child is special. Located on Briggs Road in Mount Laurel, 856-234-5292. Medford Village Car Care, serving the area's car care needs for 30 years. Located at 11 North Main Street in Medford. 609-654-4023. And on the web at mvcc-nj.com. And by Heads Up, Eyes Forward, please never drive distracted. www.lrhsd.org/heads-up. For information on how your business can become a sponsor of LDTV Sports, contact Joe Malagrana, LDTV Underwriting Manager, at 609-268-2000, extension 8680, or by email, jmalagrana@lrhsd.org. School District mobile app is now available for your iOS or Android device. The Lenape District app provides access to a variety of district information at any time from anywhere. users can quickly and easily connect with everything from district news to athletic and activity schedules to social media to grades and assignments in one mobile-friendly view. In the news stream, you can customize what information from which schools you want to follow and see all of your content all on one page. The calendar feature allows you to choose from activities, clubs, and sports from each of the district high schools so that you only see the events that interest you. And when logged into the app, students and parents can access class schedules, grades, assignments, teacher websites, attendance, and more. The app even allows students and parents to be notified whenever class grades are updated or when a cafeteria balance runs low. Even the district's Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube pages, as well as directories, teacher contact info, resources, and more are all right at your fingertips. The Lenape Regional High School District app is available for free from the App Store and Google Play. Just search Lenape Regional High School District. So get started and download the Lenape Regional High School District app today.
All right, we're coming back into the third quarter pretty soon, and Seneca really has to pick up the pace if they want to have any chance of winning this game.
Yeah, they fell behind. They got outscored there 10-2 in that second quarter and went from a four-point lead to a four-point deficit. Be interesting to see. Neither coach is probably very happy, with the offensive output of their teams.
Yeah, this game has really been a close game, and Both teams need to step it up on offense, though they're doing great on defense. It's time for the AXA Equitable Sideline Report, providing millions of customers with life insurance and annuities and other need-based products since 1859. AXA Equitable, be life confident. And now let's send it over to Bonnie Brager with the report.
Thanks, guys. The score is 15-11 with Shawnee in the lead. The Shawnee Renegades' leading scorer has 6 points, Cameron Morgan, and Seneca's leading scorer with 4 points is Jenna Birnbaum Kaminsky. We are looking forward to another great half. Thanks, guys.
All right, thanks, Bonnie. We're back to live action, and Nick Webb's going to take it out from here. Go, Nick.
Roseboro passes it back to Megan Glenn. Megan Glenn's taking it up. And Roseboro has the ball, tries to pass it up under the middle, but it's disrupted by number 11, Erica Barr.
Yeah, nice play by Erica Barr to step into the passing lane there. Seneca gets it underneath.
Thrown in by Birnbaum Kaninsky. Roseboro has it. Passes to Roseboro's driving, shoots. Didn't fall. Number 23, Lauren Lodge, had that. Cameron Morgan has the ball. Pass to Lodge, to Brecker. Back to Morgan. Morgan shoots. That's a long one, but the rebound is got. But Shawnee gets the rebound. Shoot again. Rebound by Shawnee. Shot by number 12, Olivia Shuck. Ball's loose.
Shawnee did a nice job there, Nick, keeping the ball alive. The short shot from Cameron Morgan was deflected, once it underneath the basket by another Shawnee player right after one of her teammates. So they've had at least three tries there. Now they're on their fourth try with this same offensive possession.
Shuck has the ball. Shuck to Morgan. Morgan back to Shuck. To Brecker. Shoots up, does not get it. recovered by Birnbaum Kaminsky.
Yeah, Beckler with a nice inbound pass, inside pass there to Lodge, but Lodge couldn't get the shot to fall. Beckler did a nice job.
Mullins goes back in the game. Cameron Morgan got the rebound. Passes it up to Olivia Shuck. Shot by Lodge, and she makes it.
Three-pointer for Lauren Lodge.
Roseboro passes it up to Meninsky. And out of bounds on our Golden Eagles.
Biggest lead of the game now for the Renegades at 7 points after Lodge's three-pointer makes it 18-11.
Pass in by Erica Barr. Shawnee has the ball. Erica Barr driving, passes to Shuck, to Brecker, to Lodge, now back to Morgan.
Nice and drive.
Shot.
Cameron Morgan. Beckler did a nice job there again, too. Looks like we got a Seneca timeout. Shawnee's offense beginning to flow here early in the third quarter. And
let's take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com.
Now here you see Barr and then the Beckler out top.
Just a lot of good passing
nice
there.
Nice pass over to, and a nice drive there by Cameron Morgan. Finishes it off with the basket. Cameron Morgan now with 8 points, the leading scorer for the Renegades.
Renegades offense is looking like a well-oiled machine right now.
In the third quarter, they have, yes. They've looked much better. Golden Eagles need to do something on offense. They've been a little lax with the ball to start the third quarter.
We now have both Birnbaum-Kaminsky twins in. Roseboro passes it up to Caitlin Birnbaum-Kaminsky. Caitlin passes it to Jenna Denoris. Melisco passes it back to Roseboro. Pass it to Caitlin Birnbaum-Kaminsky. She's looking, Menisco. Denoris.
Gonna get a foul there on Lodge. That'll be her first personal foul, first team foul of the second half.
Seneca was relieved that the half came with the, I think, was it 11 personal team fouls?
At least might have been. Once you get to 10, it doesn't matter if you have 11 or 12, but they gave Shawnee the double bonus. Rachel Roseboro had a pretty good look at a three there just to off shot. The iron.
Erica Barr, pass to Cameron Morgan. Now to Brecker, to Morgan.
Nice ball movement. Lodge.
Lodge shoots the three. It was close.
Denoris goes up for the rebound. They're going to get a foul on.
Looks like the foul is on Brecker, but I'm not sure.
Yeah, it is on Beckler. It'll be her second, and the second team foul for Molly Beck. Second personal on Beckler, and the second team foul. There's a steal by Beckler, but then the ball turned back over to Seneca.
Roseboro is taking it up. Taking it up, she shoots. Couldn't get it to fall. It's taken back by Olivia Shuck.
Yeah, solid rebound by Shuck. Nice move to get inside by Beckler. Can't get it to fall.
Cameron
Coming
Morgan.
Down with a third chance.
Cameron Morgan shoots.
And I think they're going to get Shuck over the back on that one.
Seneca's done a good job so far in the second half, and they have no fouls.
Sienna Vicarelli checks back in now. Molly Beckler goes to the bench.
Roseboro to Caitlin Birnbaum-Kaminsky. Jenna Denoris passes back to Roseboro. Caitlin Birnbaum-Kaminsky. There's two on her. All she can see is blue, and it's out.
Nice double-team trap over there. Nobody came to help, so... Fortunately for Seneca, Shawnee knocked the ball out of bounds.
She's looking. Nobody seems to be open. Passes to her twin, Jenna Birnbaum-Kaminsky. But it's taken. Cameron Morgan up. couldn't get that layup to fall, but it's out on Seneca. Shawnee ball.
Yeah, Caitlin did a nice job pulling down that rebound. When she did, it hit right off the tip of her foot and deflected out of bounds. Tough break. Shawnee inbounds on the side.
Vigorously pass it in to Morgan. Morgan breaking, pass under the net. Looks like that's going to be a foul on Roseboro.
And if it is, that's going to be Rachel Roseboro's fourth personal. It is against Rachel Roseboro. It's going to be a shooting foul, so that will put Erica Barr on the line for two free throws.
Misses.
Megan Glenn going to check in now, and Rachel Roseboro going to take a seat.
Eric Barr shoots, misses the second.
Good hustle by Shawnee to get the rebound, but eventually it comes into the hands of Megan Glenn.
Caitlin Birnbaum-Kaminsky looks like she's taking it up. One-on-one with Vicarelli, passes to her twin, Jenna Birnbaum-Kaminsky.
Foul called on Stephanie Hughesby. Her first personal foul, the fourth team foul on the Renegades.
Natalie Malisco, looks like she's passing it in.
Almost the opposite of what the foul situation was in the first half when the Golden Eagles committed more personal fouls.
Coach must have talked to them a lot about that at halftime. Caitlin Birnbaum-Kaminsky as the ball passes to Megan Glenn. Natalie Malisco passes it back to Megan Glenn. Passes to Malisco. And it's snatched up by Erica Barr.
Another turnover on the Golden Eagles. They just don't look like their offense is synced up tonight, Nick.
And on the other hand, Shawnee Renegades are looking like a smooth, well-oiled machine here on offense. They just keep passing around. Seneca can't seem to deflect any of these balls.
Yeah, two quick baskets by Shawnee in the first couple minutes, but we haven't had any points for about the last 4 minutes here this quarter.
Shot by Shawnee Renegades.
Yeah, Lodge misses a three ball. Ball's loose on the floor, and Shawnee gets the loose ball.
Picked up by Erica Barr.
And Coach McGovern will call a timeout. Thirty-second timeout for Coach McGovern in her fourth season here over there at Shawnee High School. Renegades' current record at 4-2, trying to get their fifth win tonight. Golden Eagles trying to even up their record. Nick, they're 3-4. It'd be a big, huge win if they could come back, but they've dug themselves quite a hole here. With a couple minutes to go in the third quarter, down by 9.
Both these teams coming off very different seasons. Shawnee coming off, I believe it was, they had 16 wins.
16-11 last year.
Seneca with only 8.
See Seneca breaking their huddle and heading back out on the court. It'll be Shawnee ball at midcourt.
Cameron Morgan has the ball. Passes it. Lauren Lodge. Recovered by Seneca, Megan Glenn.
And a nice save by Shawnee, but it happened to go right to Seneca. So let's see if Seneca can make something happen here on offense. They need a bucket. They need some points.
Pass to Natalie Malisco.
They're going to be a foul there. They're going to call that one, I believe, on Erica Barr. It is on Barr. That'll be her second personal foul, but more importantly, the fifth team foul now against Shawnee.
Seneca has done a good job of turning this foul situation around in the second half. Malisco has the ball, passes to Denoris. Shot up by Maggie Glenn, and that's a three-pointer.
Megan Glenn, just 2 field goals tonight, but both three-pointers, and the lead is down to 6 now.
Cameron Morgan has the ball. Pass to Erica Barr.
Stepped on the end line. So it'll be a turnover against Shawnee, and the ball will go over to Seneca. A little over a minute remaining in the third quarter. Molly Beckler checks back into the Renegades lineup.
Natalie Menisco throwing the ball in. Bobbled, but gotten by Jenna Norris. She's going up underneath. Manages to keep it in, but it looks like that one's going to the Renegades.
Yeah, Beckler, solid defense there by the Renegades. They come down 2-1-2.
Olivia Shucks driving up. Oh.
Off her own knee.
That's Cameron Morgan, the pass to Beckler. Beckler back to Morgan, to Shuck, to Lodge. Oh, and Lodge's pass.
Good job by Gazelle to steal. She's gonna take it down. And gonna be out of bounds, but it will remain Seneca ball. Oh, no, it was Shawnee's ball. I thought the referee pointed the other way. My mistake.
Cameron Morgan has the ball.
That'll be a kick off Jenna DeNorris' foot, so Shawnee will keep possession. 25 seconds to go in the third quarter.
Erica Barr pass to Morgan. Pass over the top.
Foul on DeNorris, her third personal, second team foul. Taylor Iacono comes in, gives DeNorris a break with her three fouls.
Morgan, pass to Beckler. Lizzie Gazelle taking it up. Trap double team. Cameron Morgan.
They get one before the end of the quarter. Bobbled loose, and that's going to end the quarter. Now, Nick, neither team put up a lot of points there in quarter number three. The Renegades scored just 5 for a three-quarter total of 20. Golden Eagles put up 3 for a game total of 14. So for the Renegades, they have increased their 4-point lead to 6. For the Golden Eagles, they need to take better care of the basketball. They turned it over a lot in that quarter.
A lot of turnovers in the Golden Eagles. But I liked how later in that quarter, they managed to turn around their defensive situation. With the Shawnee Renegades putting up a lot of points early, but Seneca managed to hold them later.
Yeah, Shawnee put up the first two possessions they had. They put up 5 points. They didn't score the remainder of the quarter, so it's a good point you made there, Nick, that the intensity of the Seneca defense really did pick up in the last half of that quarter. But they need to match that intensity on offense if they're going to come back and steal a victory here tonight on their home court. And there you see the score.
Shawnee Renegades 20, Seneca Golden Eagles 14.
Both coaches now in the huddles going over last minute instructions for their players for the fourth and final quarter. Unless we have a tie, and then of course we go to a 5-minute overtime.
Even though the Renegades are winning here, I don't think the Shawnee coach is very happy with the level of play from her players right now.
You're probably right. You're probably right.
Golden Eagles have a new player on the field, freshman Kelsey Carter. Number 30. Megan Glenn. Pass to Menisco. Menisco shoots.
Yeah, and Natalie Malesko, nice basket, her first field goal of the game. And the lead is now back down to four.
Number 23, Lauren Lodge, pass back to Cameron Morgan, pass to Beckler. Pass to Shock, back to Morgan.
Oh,
Morgan
nice drive.
Shoots and scores.
We're going to score it, and are they going to call that a block?
I don't know if you heard me, Scott. Seneca has a freshman, number 30, Kelsey Carter. In the field. Court.
She just drew the personal foul, her first. Third team foul on the Renegades. Nice drive by Cameron Morgan. Good finish. And completes the three-point play. Gives Cameron Morgan 11 points on the night now.
Jenna DeNorris. Oh. Ball recovered by
Beckler. Oh, and there's a travel, yep. Beckler got the ball, and then she handed it off to Shuck. Shuck was running almost like a halfback. I don't think she was expecting the ball to come, so they call the travel, and ball will go over to Shawnee.
Jenna Birnbaum-Kaminsky, pass in to Jenna DeNorris. Pass disrupted by Renegades. And it looks like Lauren Lodge taking it up. Pass back to Morgan. Morgan passes to Lodge, back to Morgan. Passes under to...
No basket. I think they're going to get Kelsey Carter on her second personal foul with a push. Yep. Carter draws a quick second personal foul, fourth team foul. Rachel Roseborough comes in and gives Kelsey Carter a little breather. Lauren Lodge goes hard to the basket. Nice defense by DeNorris.
Oh, I think we're going to get a charge there.
No, I think it's going to be a block because I think you're going to say Birnbaum-Kaminsky. Looks like Jenna, number 10, we'll see. Yep, her first personal foul. Now five team fouls on the Golden Eagles. Shawnee ball underneath their own basket. Nice entry pass.
Shawnee at one point had five, and that's a basket.
Olivia Shuck.
Shawnee at one point had five fouls to Seneca's one, and now it's 5-5. Seneca seems to be slipping with their fouls. Oh.
They were looking for a travel, but I think the referee's going to call this one a foul. Number five, it's going to be on Cameron Morgan, which should be her third personal. It is, and sixth team foul.
Roseborough's passing it in. And at pass in is broken up. And shot by Lauren Lodge. Picked up by Erica Barr. Oh.
Gonna be Seneca ball out of bounds. And we've got a timeout. Looks like a full 1 minute timeout called by Seneca coach Lauren Creel. Which, Nick, gives me an opportunity to thank the following people. Our crew doing an absolutely fabulous job here at tonight's girls basketball game. We've got Walter Klaus, Owen Volkerich, and Owen, if I pronounce your name wrong, I apologize. Sean Herb, Matt Mathis.
Right now we're going to go to the Ivy Rehab replay. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com.
That's the nice drive there by Cameron Morgan, then drawing the foul there on Kelsey Carter when she finishes. Continuing the crew list, we have Matt Mathis, Sean Kazanjian, Anna Olson, Kayla Doria, Eliza Sweet, Tanner George, Ryan Thomas, Kanan Lidawi, Bonnie Brager doing an absolutely fabulous job on the sideline. I'm Scott Gloucester, your play-by-play guy on his LDTV debut. Nicholas Webb doing a fabulous job here. We thank the crew. We thank the people in the truck. We couldn't get it done without your tremendous talents.
Couldn't have said it better, Scott. Back on the court.
A little over 6 minutes to go now in the game.
Megan Glenn has the ball. P- Pass to Maliska. Maliska passes to Norris. To Megan Glenn. Megan Glenn shoots. And it's the rebound is taken by Cameron Morgan going up the field.
And didn't get the shot to fall. Jenna Denaris did a nice job to interrupt that, disrupt her shot.
Roseboro has it. Shoots, couldn't get it to fall. And that's picked up by Olivia Shuck. Cameron Morgan now has the ball. The situation is looking dire for Seneca.
Well, a lot of time left, 5 minutes, but you're right. They're down by nine. They need to make a couple baskets and a couple defensive stops, cut this down to a 4 or 5 point
game. Cameron Morgan drives, misses. But it's recovered.
By Beckler.
And she shoots and scores.
Again, offensive rebounding. I think Shawnee has had the better of the offensive rebounding. Now the lead is up to 11. Biggest lead of the game for the Renegades now.
Roseboro to Glenn, to Birnbaum Kalinske. Shot by Denaris.
Just and now rolls in and out. Hasn't had much luck tonight at the offensive end for Jenna Denaris.
Cameron Morgan has the ball. Pass to Beckler. To Lodge. To Morgan. To Beckler. Shoots underneath and it's in.
Another field goal for Molly Beckler.
Shawnee's expanding on its lead. Looking to put the nails in Seneca's coffin. Roseboro up to Birnbaum. Kaminsky and Megan Glenn shoots and scores.
Megan Glenn now the leading scorer for the Golden Eagles with 8.
Cameron Morgan, pass to Erica Barr. Back to Morgan.
Shawnee timeout now with 3:40 and change.
Now, let's take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com.
That's Cameron Morgan down underneath to Beckler. Beckler with a nice move on Denaris and a good left-handed. Good use of the pivot foot and good use of the left hand by Molly Beckler. Results in a basket for the Renegades.
That was a good shot by Beckler while being guarded by the tallest person on this court, Jenna Denaris at a staggering 6'2".
The Renegades break their huddle. 11-point lead now. It's been tough go offensively for the Golden Eagles since they put up a 9 spot in the first quarter. They've only had 9 points since. Combination of their not so good handling of the ball, but also great Shawnee defense.
Cameron Morgan's pass broken up by Roseboro, but it's going right back to Shawnee as it goes out of bounds. Beckler with the pass in to Morgan. Morgan has the ball to Beckler. Passes to Lodge. Lodge is driving, shoots, and it's in. Score now, Renegades 31, Seneca Golden Eagles 18. Lodge's pass. Picked up by number 4, Aaron Wicker. Cameron Morgan to Beckler, to Lodge, to Morgan. She's looking to pass to Wicker. That shot by Lodge was picked up by Lizzie Gazelle, Seneca, but quickly
Cameron
brought
Morgan
back by the Renegades, and Morgan makes the shot.
Nice ball hawking defense there. Seneca had possession and Shuck just jumped right into the lane there and we get a blocking foul. I believe that's gonna be called on Olivia Shuck. That'll be her third personal, but that'll be the seventh team foul on Shawnee, so that will put Seneca over the limit. Their seventh team foul means Rachel Roseborough will go to the line to shoot 1-1. If she makes the first, she will get a second.
Shot. Missed. Recovered by Olivia Shuck to Wicker to Morgan.
I think they're getting an offensive foul here. 21, they're going to call Molly Beckler on the offensive foul, so it's not shooting foul, but that'll be the third foul on Beckler. 2:28 to go in the fourth. 15-point Renegade lead.
And the Renegades are walking around like they have all the time in the world.
Looks like we've got some substitutions coming in now. Sierra Sanson, number 15, has checked into the game for Shawnee.
Megan Glenn's pass broken up and caught by Olivia Shuck. Now to Morgan. Morgan has the ball. Morgan to Wicker. To Lodge.
And that's going to be on maybe Denoris. If it's Denoris, it'll be your fourth. It could be Birnbaum Kaminsky. We'll see. It is Denoris. Foul number 4 on Jenna. Sixth team foul against the Golden Eagles. So that will put Shawnee in the bonus now also. First free throw from Lodge is no good. Excuse me. She will get a second.
Shot. Missed. Grabbed by Denoris.
Pass to solid rebound there, Nick, by Jenna Denoris with a couple people trying to take the ball away from her. Showed some real strength there.
Seneca pushing in a final effort to try to catch up to Shawnee.
Be a two-shot foul. Roseborough will go to the line. Foul will be on Sierra Sanson, her first. Rachel Roseborough to go to the line to shoot a pair.
Roseborough makes the first. Shawnee subs in Vicarelli for Lodge.
Yep, Lodge probably done for the night with just a minute and 49 to go. Lauren Lodge will finish the night with 6 points.
And Roseborough makes the second. Olivia Shuck.
Oh, nice
pass.
Pass
denied by
Malesko. Good defense. Now Shawnee pulls it back out with a minute and a half to
Kevin
go.
Kevin Morgan has the ball.
I think they're going to call a foul on Maggie Glenn. Be Glenn's first of the night. 17 foul. That's going to put Cameron Morgan at the line.
Olivia Shuck subbed out.
Give her the bonus here of 1-1. If she makes the first, she gets the second. And she does make the first. Now with 14 points in the game, leading scorer in the contest.
Does not make the second. Picked up by Birnbaum Kaminsky. Taken up by Malesko.
With the foul on on Vicarelli. That'll be double bonus now because that's their 10th team foul. So Natalie Malesko will go to the line and shoot 2 shots.
Misses the first. Makes the second. Aaron Wicker has the ball. Pass to number 33, Stephanie Husseby.
Yeah, Husby. We're going to get a foul. A lot of fouls now. Pace of this game was going along pretty well here in the fourth quarter till just now. Foul is going to be on Natalie Malesko, her fourth. Eighth team foul. Malesko comes out.
Gazelle comes in. Vicarelli with the shot. Makes it.
Gives her a second one, her second point of the night.
Makes the second.
Gets a good bounce. I think we've seen the last of Cameron Morgan for the night with a minute 10 to go. 14 points she'll leave with.
Cameron Morgan killed the Seneca defense tonight.
Coach McGovern just yelling out to her squad, no fouls, no fouls. Don't give them any free points to get back into this game, even though they're down by 15.
Roseboro with the shot.
A lot of balls in and out tonight for the Golden Eagles.
Hit out by Renegades. Gazelle has the ball. Looking past to Birnbaum Kaminsky.
I think they're going to get Husby again. And it is Husby. That's going to put number 10, Jenna Birnbaum Kaminsky, on the line. She'll shoot two.
Misses the first.
And makes the
makes second. The second.
5 points in the game for Jenna Birnbaum Kaminsky tonight.
Wicker has the ball. Pass to Husby. And back to Gia Flemini. Ficarelli has it. Pass over to Wicker. Oh, jump ball. Who has the possession?
Shawnee. 23 seconds remaining in the game.
Wicker looking to pass it in. Over the top.
That's a travel. Could be the last possession for the Renegades of the night. Golden Eagles going to try to come down and get another basket before this game ends with less than 20 seconds to go now.
This basket will be about pride. Gazelle has the ball. Back to Roseboro. Shot.
And good.
And makes it. Three-pointer. This game comes to a close with the Shawnee Renegades taking the victory at 36 points. And the Seneca Golden Eagles with 25.
So you see the players going through the lines there. Nice at the end of the game, coaches talking to each other there. That's always a nice thing to see. So you see the court now cleared. Both teams are into their huddle and they'll talk a little bit about it. And you see the final score there, the Shawnee Renegades, the number 12 ranked Shawnee Renegades 36, the Seneca Golden Eagles 25. So the Renegades move to 5-2, the Golden Eagles drop to 3-5.
It's now time.
Productions are available. You can get your LDTV productions right off the internet online at youtube.com/LD Lenape District TV. You can also purchase a copy by going to lrhsd.org/LDTV copies. So you can see us online or you can purchase it. Next basketball game. Next game will be another varsity girls game, but this time it's from Cherokee High School in Marlton as the Cherry Hill East Cougars come to Cherokee and take on the Lady Chiefs. So we have fans filtering out now, Nick, and what'd you think of your first game so far on LDTV?
Well, it was definitely a great game. It's always great when two sister schools like this come together for a heated battle.
All right, we're going to throw it to our sponsors and take a few commercial breaks, and we'll be back with our play and player of the game.
Today's game on LDTV Sports, sponsored by Deborah Heart and Lung Center, where experience matters. 800-555-1990, www.deborah.org. Philadelphia Wholesale Produce Market, all the best, all right here. 215-336-3003, or on the web at www.pwpm.net. Comegno Law Group, specializing in general and special education law, representing individuals, families, public boards of education, and independent schools. 888-313-IDEA or comegnolaw.com. Wilmore School of Gymnastics and Cheer, where every child is special. Located on Briggs Road in Mount Laurel. 856-234-5292. Medford Village Car Care, serving the area's car care needs for 30 years. Located at 11 North Main Street in Medford. 609-654-4023. And on the web at mvcc-nj.com. And by Heads Up, Eyes Forward, please never drive distracted. www.lrhsd.org/heads up. For information on how your business can become a sponsor of LDTV Sports, contact Joe Malagrana, LDTV Underwriting Manager, at 609-268-2000, extension 8680. Or by email, jmalagrana@lrhsd.org. The Lenape Regional High School District mobile app.
Welcome back. We are here for the Good Hands Play of the Game, sponsored by Michael McDyer, CLTC 609-654-1426, or at michaelmcdyer@allstate.com. Allstate, you're in good hands.
Well, here is the play of the game tonight. It's the great drive, and then even though the shot didn't go, it's the offensive rebounding by Shawnee. There was a big difference in tonight's ballgame, and the second chance putback ends up being converted by Molly Beckler. So nice offensive rebound and putback by number 21, Molly Beckler.
It's now time for the Reconstructive Orthopedics Player of the Game. 1-800
896 Recon or on the web at www.reconstructiveortho.com. Let's send it down to Bonnie Brager, standing by for the interview.
Thanks, guys. I'm here with Cameron Morgan from Shawnee. So my first question is, how did you prepare for today's game?
Well, we knew we had to come into the game being like very strong, and we had to come out and we had to get on top early. So we worked on our defense, but also on our offense and finishing. But it was a very good team effort, and we all were ready today.
Very nice. And what was running through your head while actually playing the game?
I was just like thinking, like, push the ball, because we always need to get forward and get more shots. But also having good defense, and like the whole team, including me, we were all playing so well. I thought, especially on defense, because that's what we mainly focus on.
Awesome. Congratulations and good luck with the rest of your season.
Thank you.
Well, thank you, Bonnie, for that great interview with Cameron Morgan, who was the player of the game with 14 points. Did a great job tonight. You see the crowd now filtering out. And Nick Webb, in a couple of one sentence before we got to go, tell me how you enjoyed your first broadcast here on LDTV.
Well, I really enjoyed the whole experience, and what a great game. Thank you, Scott. It's been a pleasure. And final scores, Shawnee Renegades 36 and Seneca Golden Eagles 25.
For all of our LDTV crew, for Nick Webb, this is Scott Gloucester saying we'll see you next time on LDTV Sports.
This program was produced by Lenape District Television.
Do you have a plan to increase security in places like that?
The district has up-to-date and well-tested emergency response plans.